Audio Jungle. Hi you guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I am going to do a first impression of all the new makeup, or you can say it my Nykaa makeup haul video. So without further ado, let's jump into the video. First of all, for my primer as well as my moisturizer, I am using this Photo Finish Primerizer, Primer Plus Moisturizer in one from Smashbox. Now this is a travel size because I purchased bunch of product from Smashbox earlier. So they get me this travel size product. So let's try that. I'm just taking it on my hand. This much. This is really non-sticky product, I can feel, and it is really lightweight. So far so good, and it also gives a shine to your face. Like you can see here that my face is looking shiny now. But all in all, it is good na? You get primer as well as moisturizer in one product. So let's see how it works for my face. The next product is the foundation. Now for the foundation, I have never tried this brand, so it is my first purchase, and that is this Wet n Wild Photo Focus foundation in the shade Golden Beige. Now I randomly picked it because I know my shade in most of the brands, so I just went for the Golden Beige. Let's see that I am right or not. It comes with a spatula like this, so if it is your personal foundation, you can directly apply it, or if you are a professional and working with the clients, take on your like plate or your hand and then apply it, because hygiene. So I'm going to take it on my hand because I don't like to apply directly. I would say that it is not full coverage foundation. You can see the blemishes. It is medium to buildable coverage. So this is how it looks after the first layer of your foundation. But I would say that I need coverage in this here and here. Now about the foundation, this shade really matches me, thank God. It doesn't have any kind of photo flashback, so it is really great for wedding functions and all, so that you don't get flashbacks and you don't really look like ghost. So it is really good for that. And next thing I wanna say that it is really lightweight. You don't feel that you have wore like two layers of the foundation. It is really breathable. So which is a good point again. It gives like mild satin to matte finish. It is not really matte on me because I have oily skin, but if you have dry skin, I might say that it will suit you. It is not drying out totally. So it gives a good finishing and coverage. So I love this foundation. So far, let's see how it goes with the another products. So I am going to use this Maybelline Instant Age Rewind Concealer. I have the Allegirl one, so I have the best one, I guess. I didn't find the another concealer which I like. So for concealing, I am going to use this. But for my cream highlighting, again, I am going to use this Photo Focus Concealer from Wet n Wild. And the great thing about this product is this is cruelty free and it is in the shade Light Ivory. So first I'm going to use this, and then for highlighting I'm going to use this. And again, I am blending them out with the same sponge. I love the sponge for blending. It really does the magic. This kind of dries fast, so you have to work fast with this product. That I can definitely tell now. It dries really fast. So you kind of have to work fast. And thank God I haven't applied the contouring, otherwise it will be more difficult for me to blend out. So you might want to keep in mind that it also dries out, so don't apply too much under your eyes, otherwise it will dry out your under eyes and you may feel uncomfortable. Wow, I'm talking while I'm blending around my mouth. About the concealer, it is light. It is kind of light, but thank God that I have mixed it with the Maybelline one, so it is not the ghostly white, but it is kind of light, so I have to work with it like mixing another foundation or concealer in it. So now for my cream contouring. I know I don't use cream contour products much, but for the sake of this video and I really wanted to try, so I gave it a try, this LA Girl Pro Conceal in the shade Beautiful Bronze. You wanna create a tree like, so you can contour easily like this. And Ulta 3 and around my mouth. Now take care about nose contour, because the wider you contour, the bigger the nose will look. So try to keep the lines really near to each other so that it snitch the nose. Yeah, so this is my contour. And just blending it and not swiping it, because I will move the foundation otherwise. So I'm just pushing it into the skin. And I have also created an IGTV for my all the contouring questions and queries. So if you wanna know, please go to my Instagram at shraddu.parmar and you'll find the IGTV on contouring, which is specially dedicated for contouring. So you guys will have exact idea. Blended everything out, like my contour and my highlight. About the contouring product, I have used many of these LA Girl concealers for my concealing, not my contouring. So I like this, really a rich brown color, so take care when you use it, otherwise this product is really good. I love LA Girl concealers a lot. And now for the powder setting, I am using this Revolution Banana Baking Powder. Like, this is luxury baking powder in banana shade, so I'm going to use it under my eyes, and for the rest of my face I'm just using the regular MAC one or Maybelline one. I'll see what I'm going to use, but for my under eyes I'm using this baking powder. I have never used it, so let's see. Brightens the under eye, so I'm just going to use this much because I don't want my eyes to look pale. So for my face I'm using this MAC mineralized foundation powder in the shade medium. So for the face I'm just setting it out, and if you don't have oily skin, you don't need to set your whole face. If you are a dry skin person, bless you, because you don't have to set all of your, like, really all of your face. Just set the T-zone and you're good to go. But we have to, so we are doing it. now for the contour, I'm using this Nykaa Contour and Conquer in the shade Sizzle Chisel. I really wanted to try this. It has like a brown color and a shiny shade like highlighter. I thought it would be matte, but it is shiny. So you get like a travel size packet, like contour and highlight. Pretty good. So I'm taking this shade on this brush and just going to contour where, like, all over where I have applied the liquid contour. Now this is kind of an ashy shade. The beautiful bronze was a like brownish, reddish and more chocolatey shade, but this is kind of an ashy shade. It's like perfectly pigmented, not less, not more. So I like this product. The pigment is good and it is not that powdery, so you don't have to worry about much of the product waste. And for the nose contour, I am using the Chhotu Wala brush and lightly just dust it out, because otherwise my nose will look this much chhotu and I don't want that. Just setting the cream contour if anywhere needed. So yeah, so overall this product is really good. I like the pigmentation and the shade. I'm not disappointed with this product, so yeah, I like it. So now for the blush, I have purchased this Fit Me Maybelline in the shade Nude Peach. I was really into peach shades lately and I really wanted to try a peach blush, because earlier I was all about the pinky baby. I loved pink blush. I love them now also, but I really like this kind of peachy nude shades. So let's try how pigmented it is. So I'm taking it on this brush and just applying lightly on the apples of my cheeks. And the great thing about this blush is this is matte, so if you have texture on your cheeks you can still apply it, because the blush sometimes have that glitter or pigments in it, so you cannot apply if you have texture on your cheeks because it will exaggerate that. But this is matte, so you can totally apply it. Yeah, I like it. This is kind of your everyday blush. You can wear it in office, you can tone it down, or you can just apply more according to your choice. But you can also apply it in your office or your college going girl.
Not in right now because all the colleges are closed, so sorry. Offices are also closed, but still I love this blush.
So I like this blush. This is light color, you can apply it on your, like, it is your casual everyday kind of blush. I like this color. If you are a coral lover, you are definitely going to love it. This is about the Maybelline Fit Me blush. The pigment is really good, so you are not wasting your money. I like. So next is my favorite product, the highlighter, and I have purchased this Nykaa Glow Getter highlighter duo in the shade 24K Glam. Now this has another variant, the Glitterazzi or something, but I was more into this, so I purchased this. Now this is like this. It has a golden and a browny peachy, not browny but bronzy peachy shade. If the camera picks up so or not, I don't know, but this is a bronzy peachy shade. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to mix the both and apply it on the apples of my cheeks. So this is pigmented, not like the Maybelline Master Chrome one, that is bomb, but this is also pigmented. So I like this. It is kind of a natural in between, like not natural and not the bomb highlighter. So I won't say it is subtle, it is definitely not subtle, but this is not the bomb also, but I like it. Yeah, it is pigmented. You will like it if you love the natural not exactly natural but somewhat highlighting effect. This is the product you can buy. Choose your shade. They have another variant too. So now next for the eyebrows, I have bought this Etude House drawing eyebrow. I will mention everything about all the products in the description box below, so don't forget to check it out because I cannot find the shade right now. So once you get this product in this shape, like it's a triangular, small triangular shape, and on the other side you get this pulley. I love the products which has pulley with it because you don't need other brush and which is really convenient to use. So I'm just going to comb my eyebrow, and the packaging is really sturdy. It doesn't feel like a cheap product, it is really sturdy. So I'm just going to lightly draw my eyebrows. Ooh, that matches exactly to my eyebrows. Like the color is exact to my brows. It is really not dark, not the light, and the pigment is really good, and the product is not that soft. So you have the control of the product and you can draw the desired shape of your eyebrows, which is really good. I like this. So this is how my eyebrows look, and I like it because it is almost the exact shade of my brows, and the product is not as hard or as creamy. It is the perfect consistency, so you get the control of your like pencil and draw the desired shape of your eyebrows. So I like it. I haven't purchased any of the product of Etude House. This is my first purchase and so far I'm loving it. So the next product is eyeshadow. Now I have purchased this Nykaa Eyes On Me Tanning One Eyeshadow Palette in the variant Beachside Peach. It comes with a brush and it is mostly matte shades. It has three shimmer shades and they all are mostly corally beachy colors. So let's start. First of all, for my crease, I am going to use this orangey corally shade. Now for my outer corner, I'm just using this color, teeny tiny bit. I'm not going to use a lot. Now the one thing that I have noticed that you can have slight tiny bit of a fallout. So take care about that, as in when you like notice fallout, just flick it away. You don't want it to settle. Now for my lid shade, I'm just taking this creamy light peachy shade and I'm going to use this brush. Yeah, this works. It works really well. I like this brush. And for my lower lash line, I am just using this dark brown shade and just mix it with this orangey shade. Now for my inner corners and my brow bone highlighter, what I am going to do is I am going to use this shiny shade from the contouring palette and apply it in my inner corner as well as my brow bone. And now for my mascara, I am using this Flower Beauty Lash Warrior Mascara. I have heard a lot about it, so I really wanted to try it for a longer period of time now. So let's see how it actually works. Okay, it has this kind of brush. First, I'm going to use on my lower lash. I have straight eyelashes, I hate it. Do you guys also have it? I have to like really curl them with the lash curler, like atyachar karti hu main. Aur koi option hai to please bata do. But I haven't used lash color this time. I'm just using this mascara and I am loving it. How it lifts the lashes and like adds the volume to the lashes. I love it. Now the last thing, my super favorite, I cannot live without it, the lipstick and the lip liner. Now for the lip liner, I have purchased Nykaa Lips Don't Lie in the shade Pillow Fight. I have purchased a bunch of Nykaa products this time because I really wanted to try them. So let's see how this Pillow Talk comes out. Now this shade is something like this. So, I'm just lining my lips first. They are really smooth, it glides on really easily. You don't have to scratch your lips for it. And they are pigmented. But the thing I don't like about my lip liners are I like to have a retractable ones instead of this kind of a sharpening ones, because you lost the product in sharpening these things. So I love the retractable products like lipsticks or lip liners, everything. So now for the lipstick, again this is from Nykaa. This is their Ultra Matte range and this shade is Mona Lisa. This is kind of a peachy brownie shade. So I'm just okay. Now about this products, they are really really matte. You can feel the matteness from applying it itself. You have to give a pressure to like move it on. So this is really a matte product and a bullet lipstick. I love it. I love the combination. And your lips don't feel dry. My lips are desert dry. Like they are really dry, but it is not feeling dry right now. So the combination of the Nykaa lip liner and the Nykaa lipstick is good for my lips. And they both are really pigmented and I love the color so much. This is kind of a beachy, corally like look right now. And I am loving this. A setting spray. I have purchased it for the first time. This is Maybelline New York Lasting Fix Makeup Setting Spray Matte Finish. The spray is not harsh, but I don't like the smell. It doesn't smell good like the pack one. I love the pack one. It is the best for me. It smells slightly chemically, but otherwise right now it is good. I will tell the after effects, like how it settles into matte finish or not. So stay tuned for this thing. And also one question I got from my last video, that I have used the VLCC sunscreen on my face or not. So I haven't used it for my face. I use Dermed prescribed product, the photo stable sunscreen. So I really don't know about the VLCC product, that it is sensible, skin friendly or not. So I'm sorry about that. I use it for my body and so far my body is really comfortable with it. I didn't have any rashes because I'm pretty sensitive about things. So for my body, I really didn't get any rashes or anything else. So for my body it is good. For my face, I haven't tried, so I'm not going to say anything about the face. So that's it for the video, you guys. I hope you like it, and if you find it helpful, please subscribe to my channel. This means absolute world to me. And I am going to link every product in the description box below so that you can find and check it out if you like some of it. And I created this look. If you like it, please give a thumbs up and please hit the bell icon so that you get notified every time I post a new video. I'll see you in my next video. Till then, take care. Mwah.